Hi, and welcome to this makeup tutorial. Today, we will take a closer look at some tricks related to eyeshadows. In order to follow this tutorial, you will need Blender with a functional installation on MPFB. Further, you will need a character with a make skin material and preferably a rigify rig. Outside Blender, you will need an image editor. In the video, I will use GIMP, but the corresponding functionality should be available in most image editors. In the video, it is assumed that you have watched the Getting Started with Makeup video. You can find links to that video and to GIMP in the description of the video. There are two parts in this video. In the first part, the goal is to produce a discrete and unassuming faded eyeshadow. To start with, I'll create an ink layer for the eyeshadow. The trick I'm going to use will require a bit more space than just the eyelids. Thus, I will opt for the eyes wide solid focus, even though the narrow one might have fit better. Since we want detail, I'll go for a full 4K by 4K texture. Then I'll enter pose mode and lower the eyelids for easier access. Now we can hide the rig. In the texture paint editor, I'll make sure that we are in material preview mode and that the ink layer is selected. Then I'll make sure that X symmetry is enabled. I'll pick a darker than skin tone color. Now let's paint the general area we want the eyeshadows to occupy. For my goal, I'll paint roughly the area up to the eyebrows. It does not matter that this looks a bit severe at the moment. We'll address this in a later step. This will have to do for now. For the coming trick to work, it is important to fill the entire eye area and not leave any holes. Now we will save this image somewhere and instead open it in GIMP. Now for the trick. I'll apply a Gaussian blur here. Let's try 100px to start with. I overwrite the image. Back in Blender, I reload it. The faded area is too wide for my taste. Let's switch back to GIMP and change it. We'll Ctrl Z and instead use an 80px blur. Overwrite again. And reload. Now I'm thinking the effect is too strong. I'll want something more discreet. Back to GIMP. Let's add a transparent layer. We move the layer so that it is at the bottom. Now we can modify the opacity of the ink layer. Again, we overwrite the image. And we reload it in Blender. Let's render on the layered skin in order to make a comparison. As the goal was a discrete and unassuming eyeshadow, I'm satisfied. Now this trick can be used for more than just fading a one color eyeshadow. For the second part, I will instead go for a rainbow eyeshadow. We'll start over with a clean character and a new ink layer. I'll use the same settings as previously. This time, I'll use strong colors. The actual colors doesn't matter much. Pick what suits your preferences. I'll paint vertical stripes across the eyes using colors around the palette. Now we fill in the blanks. Again, it is important to also paint the center of the eye area. I'll trim the lines a bit too. Remember that you can use Erase Alpha to remove superfluous color. Same procedure as last time. We save the image and open in GIMP. Apply Gaussian blur. Reload in Blender. Nope, I'm not satisfied with the shape. Control Z in GIMP and overwrite. Reload in Blender. Let's change it around a bit. Save and back to GIMP. Blur and overwrite. Reload in Blender. This I can live with. Let's render side-by-side comparison on the layered skin for this too. Maybe a bit drag queenish, but I'm sure you get the idea. Anyway, that's it for this short makeup tutorial. I hope you enjoyed it. Thank you for watching this video, and happy modeling!